کلینیک شنوایی نوبل در وست ونکوور با مدیریت دکتر رحیم قنبری.
ما در کلینیک شنوایی نوبل در وست ونکوور آماده ارائه خدمات تخصصی در زمینه شنوایی و سمک هستیم.
شماره 1475 مارین درایو، تلفن 604-281-1475.
من مهناز کاووسی هستم، مشاور املاک از شرکت ریمکس ماسترز.
مهناز کاووسی، مشاور املاک در ونکوور بزرگ، ارائه دهنده خدمات خرید و فروش املاک مسکونی و تجاری، تلفن 604-779-4146.
This outfit is from northwest of Iran, Tabriz. And so this dance is going to be Turkish, Azeri, Azerbaijan. And it's from northwest of Iran. I hope you like it. There's no particular story behind it, but it's basically just to bring joy. And people, it's called Şadlık, which means happiness. And it's people do it when they're in their eight celebrations or New Year's. So I hope you like it and I hope you enjoy. Give yourself a round of applause. Thank you.
من مهناز کاووسی هستم، مشاور املاک از شرکت ریمکس ماسترز.
مهناز کاووسی، مشاور املاک در ونکوور بزرگ، ارائه دهنده خدمات خرید و فروش املاک مسکونی و تجاری. تلفن 604-779-4146. کلینیک شنوایی نوبل در وست ونکوور با مدیریت دکتر رحیم قنبری.
ما در کلینیک شنوایی نوبل در وست ونکوور آماده ارائه خدمات تخصصی در زمینه شنوایی و سمک هستیم.
شماره 1475 مارین درایو. تلفن 604-281-1475.
The work that we do here on Indigenous rights is what we share all over the world, and we have some big trips coming up to France and to Panama, and potentially New Zealand. So I'm always excited and happy to travel with hereditary chief, spiritual leader. Not many people know, but a graduate of Harvard, associate professor of Lethbridge University. But first and foremost, he is one of our spiritual leaders. I'd love to have my uncle, Phil Lane, come and share.
Mitakiepi, my very, very beloved relatives of the human family. I'm very, very thankful to be here on this unsurrendered, unceded land of the Tsleil-Waututh, Musqueam, Squamish, and all the other great members of the Salish Nation. And I really want to just say a few things here. We've got, I can hear tuning up behind me this beautiful, beautiful music. But I want to really have us give a real reflection on the Tsleil-Waututh Nation, because they're a demonstration of the incredible power and strength and spiritual potentiality of the human family. At one time, across along this inlet, there was 10,000 Tsleil-Waututh people, 10,000. Before the smallpox was over, before, which by the way, were also given as gifts by relatives who came here from Europe purposely to infect indigenous people here, members of the human family here, they were eventually reduced to 13 human beings. From 10,000 to 13 human beings. Can you imagine what it would be like to have a community of 10,000 people very, very closely related and be reduced to 13 people from 10,000? And by the way, for most people don't realize this, in this hemisphere of the Americas, there was 100 million indigenous people living here prior to contact, when, as was destined, we joined and met here in this hemisphere. 100 million, reduced down to about 5 million. But not only did the Tsleil-Waututh come back from 13 people, but they have become a economic powerhouse, but has directed that economic power towards their community. So you have almost full employment there in Tsleil-Waututh for all their members. So it hasn't been for just a few. It's been for the people, the way it should be. Because the extremes of wealth and poverty, wherever you find it on Mother Earth, is a sign of tyranny. The extremes of Mother Earth, where 2 billion human beings on this planet, you don't have clean water, you don't have a place to live and put their head down, you don't have education. This is something that has to change. And that's why I look at Tsleil-Waututh and the way they've come back. Now you can imagine, when you come from 10,000 people to 13, how you might feel about other people who come to your territory who've done that. It would be real easy to carry within your heart a lot of hatred and bitterness. But right here in Ribbon George, you can see the love and kindness and compassion. Not only has this nation come back from 13 people, but they're hosting gatherings like this that talk about us coming together as a human family. And as well, this Keystone, this Kinder Morgan pipeline, there are the people who stood up and have spent tremendous amounts of resources to launch a legal case there, to do their own environmental assessment of what's going on. They have been leading the whole charge on the Kinder Morgan pipeline that could destroy, as we saw from that oil spill in English Bay, this entire beautiful area. Now, the other thing I want to add is one of the principles I believe in is the equality of men and women. I believe the eagle of humanity has two wings, one is man and one is woman. Until both of these eagles' wings and this eagle are respected, the eagle of humanity will never fly its highest. The Tsleil-Waututh Nation, what an example. They have a woman chief, and out of five counselors, out of five members, four are women and one are male. I think that's something in this day where we men of Mother Earth have led us into this condition we find ourselves today, where we're destroying our Mother Earth, where we find such injustice, where we find this incredible inequality and oppression going on, whether it be any place on this Mother Earth. And I want to say also, in respecting and honoring the great nation of Iran that was here before, I want us to remember this. In 1952, I think it was 1953, Iran had the first democratically elected government in that part of the world. It was the first democratically elected government, and that government, because they wanted the oil, was overthrown by the United States government and the government of England. And look at the problems that have been created by not allowing this nation, which decided its own democracy, clear back in 1952 and 53, was 52 or 53? Huh? 1952. The first democratically elected government in that part of the world. Taken down because they wanted to have their own oil resources. So I want to honor the people of Iran for what's happened and what you've gone through. And for those that have come out here and realize we are one human family. We're 99.9% the same. Although our differences is of the beautiful cultures and spiritual gifts we have. So that's about what I wanted to say. But again, I think we owe a big hand and thanksgiving to the Tsleil-Waututh Nation for their strength, for their ability to come back from 10,000 down to 13, come back, love the human family, stand up for Mother Earth, and do what they're doing here. So join me, please, in standing up and giving them applause, the Tsleil-Waututh Nation and the Salish people. So thank you very, very much. I really appreciate this opportunity. I really, you know, my nephew here is kind of humble. But in a few years, I've watched him come. I knew him as a little boy, little guy, which is not a little guy now. But from coming from a really tough background in terms of many, many First Nations, he's become a really internationally recognized leader in this world about loving the human family, about loving all and respecting all people's spiritual faith. So Haole Michante Washtelo, Shuk Mano Hemeyado, Shinupasapa Hemeyado. In our Dakota language, when we finish speaking, we say our names. My name is a sacred black pipe born of thunder, lightning, and rain. My name is a leader of warriors who takes the enemy's best horses, and I stand responsible before the Creator for my words and my action. Haole Michante Washte. Hope.
I want to thank our Uncle Phil for his kind words and for his many years of contributing to activism. Thank you for your many years of activism. Okay, so our next act, I'm honored to introduce you, is the Vashon Ensemble. They're gathering together some of the finest classically trained Persian musicians in Canada. The Vashon Ensemble draws upon Iran's rich musical past to perform joyful and memorable Persian traditional songs. The Vashon Ensemble was formed in 2011 as a project to explore and present forms of Iranian music that have rarely been heard internationally. The ensemble has since continued to explore a broad range of traditional Persian music styles and lovingly perform for a wide range of North American audiences. The Vashon Ensemble, everyone. Thank you.
Salish people for this beautiful territory that we're on. To my right, you're listening to Ali Sajadi. He's playing the oud.
Yeah.
Next to him is Saina Khalidi. The instrument she's playing is a santur.
Yeah.
It's a 72-string dulcimer. Ali Razmi on vocals and the Persian tar. Gordon Gardina, he's playing the Arabic oud.
Yeah.
My name is Hamin, I'm playing the tombak, and this instrument is called daf.
Yeah. Oh.
The next piece we're going to play is a piece of Ali's. It's called Morde Budam, and it's symbolic of coming to life from the death, and it's not literal. It's kind of the death that you feel inside and the life that you can achieve through inspiration and through love.
Rafna Modi Go
Cultures, different languages, even different styles of music. So we're gonna try and honor the Kurdish people by playing a piece of theirs. After we tune a little. Thank you.